Once upon a time. It was the best of times. It was the worst of times. There was a girl. And she rode upon the back of a great fox. But they were lost. They had always been lost. Until a path appeared. And so she followed. Was the path leading her? Or was she leading it? She didn't know. It was just there. All of a sudden, she knew where she was. She was home. The woods had sheltered her as a child. The path was blocked before her. The path stretched deeper into the forest. She remembered animals frolicking in the glades. She remembered planting flowers. She felt the woods begin to wake up around her. Who? Where? Why? What? She remembered exploring the twisted paths. She remembered discovering precious stones. The more she remembered, the stronger she felt. Dangers awaited beyond the forest. She had to be strong before she could leave. I am not a writer. This is not my muse. She would have to burn the brambles before she could pass through them. She remembered finding magical things in the underbrush. Sensing a terrible wrongness, she looked up. and fire fell from the sky. Had a star died? Had the moon fallen? She didn't know, but she wasn't home anymore. Chitinous chattering creatures began to appear. Insectile things which sought to hurt her. With their scything claws and gnashing maws. They should not be here. She headed towards the source of fire, because if she didn't, who would? The trees began to give way to ash and char. This was where the meteor had struck. The path ended here. She found herself alone. Lost in darkness. Until fire roared behind her. The meteorite had buried itself deep. Wicked things crept from its dark core. Briar and bramble blocked her path. Ancient paintings covered the walls. Telling the story of another world, or perhaps another life. Loneliness seeped out of them.
Save it.
The cavern closed in around her, suffocating. They came from the darkness, like fear manifest. And only fire could save her. She saw something across the lava, a power which the meteor could not destroy. Something new flowed through her veins. It burned away the loneliness inside and revealed new paths all around her.
We'll be friends now. I'll look after you. I promise.
The maze began to crumble before her. Nothing could stand in her way now. Paintings began to look familiar to her. Thank you. The cavern opened up before her, like a cathedral. And there stood the meteor's heart. Braced herself for the final onslaught. Before long, the fires calmed, a stillness descended, and her heart danced a new beat. She emerged once more into the light. Though the ground would be forever marked, green shoots of new life surrounded her. Foulness still festered here. The bitter taste of corruption clung to the land like a scar. To the north stretched the forest. Heady smells of pine and moss drew her closer. Thank you. And then she saw the shadow within. The forest was a place of light and peace, but she barely recognized it. Beneath the darkness of shadow and silk. The forest resisted her approach, but she knew its secret language. The forest opened to her with heavy heart. The woods thinned, growing shy. She began to fear the emptiness, more than she feared the shadows. She helped the forest to grow. Write our initials in the bark. Then we'll be together forever. They came from Nest of Darkness. But she was strong before them. Forest sighed in relief.
What's going on? Why won't you answer me?
The forest closed to her once more. She didn't understand why. Sometimes it tried to guide her in its way. Forst yearned for her to wander deeper. There was something rotten here. The forest was but an echo of itself. Creeping cobwebs choked. Sinister shadows spoiled. It needed to be freed. She burned away the blight, but the forest would learn to love once more. We planted this seed together. I will always love you. The forest gave to her its trust. And they were finally united. She shunned the waves of darkness. The sun began to shine.